Extend your winning streak with a new weapon with the Yonex VCORE SV 100 Plus. Yonex introduces another extended length version to their racquet lineup with the VCORE SV 100 Plus. The racquet still has its signature isometric head shape for a generous sweet spot and a 3D vector shaft for increased stability. New SV frame technology is present in the frame, which combines a flexible carbon Nanometric XT material with an aerodynamic bean shape. It features an 11.2 ounce strung weight, a 341 swing weight, and a 70 stiffness rating. First up, we have Jason. Now, you got to play test the extended length version of the E-Zone DR100. What do you think of the extended length of this VCORE SV?
Well, I thought that DR100 Plus was a very powerful racquet, and this SV100, I felt, had even more power. On my groundstrokes, I found just great access to power, easy depth, and I felt like it had great plow through and torsional stability, especially up at net. But I felt like the one shot I kind of did struggle with was the shots kind of high above my head. I just kind of couldn't get the ball, the racquet through contact as easily there. On serve, I kind of had cheated like with the DR100 Plus, where I kind of choked up on the racquet. Once I did that, I was serving fine with it, and I actually felt like I was getting plenty of pop on my serve there. The one negative for me though was that this racquet did feel pretty stiff compared to the DR100 Plus and my own racquet, Pure Strike. Overall, I felt like this is a very powerful racquet, and I feel like it is a good choice for intermediate players that are looking to maximize the power on their strokes.
Next up, we have Tiffany. Now, both of us are big fans of Yonex rackets, especially the 100-inch ones. We have another racket to add to that list. What were your thoughts?
Well, I really did enjoy this one, and I think the only disadvantage this SV100 Plus had is that I was testing it alongside the DR100 Plus. This racket offers a ton of power, a little less control than the DR100 Plus, so that's why I prefer the DR100 Plus over this SV. This one was effortless power, a little too much. I was not able to control it as well. I couldn't produce the same amount of spin as I could with the regular standard length SV100 to get my ground strokes to drop in confidently every time. And as I moved to net, again, I missed that spin on the approach shot, so I was missing some of those wide as well as long. But at net, I really enjoyed the stable feel, and I thought that the put-away power was very excellent. And serve, again, I always like extended length rackets on serve. Just gives me added power. This one, again, to the DR100 Plus, was a little bit harder for me to control, but I really liked it. And I think I would have liked it even more if I hadn't tested it alongside the DR100 Plus.
Next up, we have Hannah. Now, you play tested the standard length version of this SV100. How'd you like this extended length version? How'd it compare?
I really liked this extended length version. Actually, I preferred it over the standard length version. It really offset some of the feel issues that I had with the regular one. I'm not sure why, but the stability and leverage definitely helped with that, I think. I got easy put-away power. And then the maneuverability of the standard length version was really prominent in this version as well for me. So pickups from the baseline were still easy, and that's rare for an extended length racquet, I feel like. So I really liked this on ground strokes because I could still get a lot of spin, but also I really had that power as well. Also the pop on serves just gave me an extra weapon. Good stability on volleys, which I feel like the standard length didn't have that, and I was missing that. And then lastly, my favorite shot was the returns. I could go after them and really step in and get on the offensive.
I also play tested this racket, and I was super excited to get out on court because I'm a big fan of Yonex rackets and really enjoyed the previous DR100 Plus play test. So I was excited to see what this one had to offer. And like the other play tester said, right off the bat with my ground strokes, I found this to have a lot of easy power, like a lot of power. I checked my play site data on my ground strokes, and both my average and my max speeds were well over my current racket of choice, which is the E-Zone DR100. So I really liked how much power, how hard I could hit with this racket. But with that, it did come with a little downside of I lost a little bit of consistency because I was just having too much fun hitting out, and I was overhitting and missing the ball a little bit more than I normally do. Another thing I thought was interesting was I thought it was more maneuverable than the spec indicated. It says it's around 341 swing weight, and I definitely thought it swung a lot faster than that. Like the E-Zone DR100 Plus, when it came to serves, I did struggle a little bit. I had a bit of an adjustment period as a lot of my serves were landing long, so I had to really focus on getting my wrist snap to get that ball to drop in the service box. Lastly, I want to finish up with serve returns. They were my favorite shot to hit with this racket. I loved the power I got. It was controllable, as well as the maneuverability and the feel. I could just definitely swing out on first serves or second serves and start the point off on the offense. Overall, I think this is another great offering in the extended length category. And between the two Yonex rackets, I really can't make a decision on which one I like better. We strung up this VCORE SV 100 Plus with Vocal Cyclone at around 52 pounds. For more information on this racket, please check it out online at tenniswarehouse.com or one of our fine affiliates.